We have a very good question from Nema. What are you guys most certain about from this project? What are you hoping to learn and unlearn from it? Yeah, tough question. Tough question. We've been arguing about it for a few minutes.
Off air.
Yeah, off air, off air. But I feel like we've handled a bit of what we hope to learn and unlearn in other answers. So we will combine this with another question you have.
So yeah, this is an Instagram question, and Mildred Sakina asks, what's the most surprising thing about Africa you have discovered on your previous trips? And how does it feed into this one?
Mm-hmm. In arguments, Josh seemed to be the most shit. So you can start for us.
Wow. My folks were missionaries. So we used to travel a lot. Yeah. And I think the most surprising thing about Africa is how alike we are in tradition, culture, language, and yet how we're still so divided in so many ways. I think it's baffling. There are other continents where that share cultures like that, like Asia and whatnot, and maybe I think Asia. But with Africans, for some reason, and I think that leads to this unscrambling idea, where people are so alike in tradition, in belief, and yet we're so different. It's crazy. My example of that is even with food, for example. We have ugali in Kenya. We have pap in Mese and Zim and a lot of Southern Africa.
Malawi has sima.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. There are a lot of words in Malawi that are similar to Swahili as well.
Yeah.
There's so much, and yet at the same time, that bothers me. Really bothers me, because I feel we should be more united, more. And I think that trip is a trip of discovery. You know, why are we so different?
Yeah.
Even here in Kenya, people who live 100 or 200 kilometers away from each other, night and day.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then what other thing is I think also another thing is how. And it's sad that we have to go back to this, but how European influences.
That was.
I'm sorry to take this. How European influences have just trickled down and made us so different as well.
Yeah.
The Francophone countries, you know, the English speaking countries, and then there's a huge difference.
Yes.
So, and I think. Maybe that's enough. I think there's one more, but I forgot. I think I'll get back to it. But I think those things are surprising in so many ways. And yeah, so this will be interesting. I think we need to go around. And it's not... Somebody else.
So I'll kind of add on to yours. I think, the thing that I found most surprising is how our history, and especially our colonial histories, have shaped different countries in different ways. So, you know, apartheid in South Africa, and, you know, the consequences of that you see now in terms of socioeconomic life, you know, between different people. If we look at TZ and, you know, post-colonialism, then the whole socialism system and how that is seen today. So just those differences in terms of our political history and how those have shaped, you know, when you combine that with our culture and, you know, with that now our modern aspirations, like just how all those things mix together and create a different way in a different country. I think that's surprising, interesting. It will be interesting to see more countries and how all of those things play into life for Africans.
I think the most surprising thing for me would be how much Africans in different countries want to experience being an African in another country.
Mm-hmm.
Like, initially, the way I used to perceive an African was like, you know, Ghanaian, Nigerian.
I still, you know. And I wonder why I got my name.
Yes.
You feel, I feel small on it.
Exactly. Yeah. Or Zulu, you know. And you know,
you feel like they feel more African.
Yeah, like they, like, you know, when I think of African, that's, yeah, you know, what comes to mind. But surprisingly, this once I was in Accra and they felt like Kenyans were like
Africans.
You know?
Interesting.
And,
you know,
yeah,
yeah. You know, you go to Tanzania and they're like, oh, you're from Kenya. Kenya is very nice. I should go to Kenya one day. You know. And it's the same for me. Like, I really want to go to Zimbabwe. I really want to go to SA.
Yeah.
And it's interesting how the only thing that keeps us from doing that is our governments, pretty much. Yeah.
It is amazing how just from one side of the border to the next, people are totally different.
Mm.
At the border. We're not even talking about past the border by 50 kilometers.
Mm.
Like, the way the people on this side of the border behave on this side, you will, if you slept, you were sleeping and you woke up on the other side, you'd know, I'm not in the same place.
Mm.
Right? We must be somewhere different because of the way people behave. Like, and for me, I always feel like cities have like a character, like a person.
Yeah.
And different places feel a different way. Like, the way Kigali to me was, you know, this gentleman or lady who walks upright, doesn't slouch ever, always clean, whether it's fashionably or office style, but it's clean, you know, might not be the funniest person in the room, but they're the dependable person.
Yeah.
You know, they're the people who, if you need business to go through, talk to Kigali.
Yeah.
They'll get it done for you.
Yeah.
While on the other side in Bujumbura, it felt like if you want to have a party, you need Bujumbura.
Yes.
In there, yeah. And not Kigali.
Yeah.
They might not be the ones that you go to when you want to do serious business. But you know, and I hope people are not offended. This is just observations of different places. And Kampala is the fast-paced place where people don't seem to be going anywhere. And then Nairobi would be the cosmopolitan person, but who is given to bouts of anger. They can be fun and they can work hard, but volatile. And that's, you know, like that's Nairobi. So it's the place where it's nice, and if you need to get things done during the day and have a good party in the night, be in Nairobi. But in that, you also kind of have to be careful, because push too many buttons and a punch might come to your face. Yeah, and that's what I feel. And I wonder what all these other cities, what their characteristics are.
Mm.
That's one of the things that I'm looking forward to most. Mm. And if I'm to preempt and even jump on the certainty question that Nema asked, I'm not certain of much in this project, but the one thing that I'm certain of is that if we are in a place, the film that we will shoot and the photos that we will make will be a true representation of what we feel about this place.
Mm-hmm.
That one I'm sure about.
Yeah.
There's not too much I'm sure about, but that is it.
Yeah.
If we are in these places, then the stuff we will take, I think it will be the perfect representation. It might not be the perfect representation of them, because I feel that takes time, but it will be the perfect representation of what we feel this place is. Not the only one, but the one that is closest to us. And that's what we want, something, a real representation of what we feel about a place, about the people, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So we just want to be real, and that one I'm certain that we will be.
Yeah.
And
I'm certain that it's going to be a life-changing experience.
Sure. Yes, that is
for sure.
I am very sure about that.
And I'm just like really excited to see in what ways it will be so, but I know it definitely will be.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm certain we will run into authorities. Just curious ones, not that they want to cause any trouble. we have, I mean, faced that in all, I think.
Remember the African the guys who stopped
us in a big truck.
Yeah, and AKs.
Oh, wow.
It was a full...
They surrounded us like...
Yeah.
Wow.
And we knew it's over.
We already
then after all that, they just asked us to open the wipers, lights, full light, low light, brake light. Okay, where are you from?
Okay,
continue. You're like, why all the guns? Like, Trevor, no, this is just for emphasis.
Emphasis.
Just for emphasis.
Yeah, but for sure it will be a life-changing experience and something we will never forget and something we hopefully will help people to never forget.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It will be timeless. It will be amazing.
That's a good place to end the Q&A.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Thank you to everyone who sent questions, who asked things. There are so many more questions that we haven't answered, but I think we will get down into Instagram or Twitter and Facebook where you ask them and just answer as many questions as we can over there. We will also link previous videos that we've done about Unscramble in Africa, about our own projects, things that people ask that were not necessarily for this. We'll link them all down in the comment section. What else? And the link to the Kickstarter will also be there. We hope that this video just gives you a little bit of insight on, you know, like the things that we're interested in capturing, why we are doing this, why we are crowdfunding. Because we hope we've shown you the importance of why we think the project is valid, why we feel we have to do it.
Yeah.
And we hope that you can keep giving. We've had quite a number of backers, and thank you so much everyone who's given a dollar, a pound, whatever. We are very grateful. We need to definitely push more.
Yeah.
So if you're holding out on us, don't be. Come on, it's the holidays.
Don't be like that.
Don't be the guy who this trip fails because of pressure. No pressure. But yeah, so keep giving, keep pledging. We have, I think, by the time this video is out, we'll have maybe 26 or 24 days, somewhere there.
Yeah.
So let's do this. Let's do this.
Yeah.
Africans, out of Africans, if you feel this is important,
yeah,
give. We will also have the link to the Kickstarter down.
And share. Like that is, almost equally as important.
Yes.
Just spread the word. We appreciate it.
Yeah. If you know anyone who will give who doesn't know us, share to them.
Yeah.
Share to 10. Yeah. Let's make this a pyramid scheme. Not the scheme, but the pyramid part. Yeah, we have cool gifts. We're doing a book. We're doing videos, a documentary. We are doing a coloring book. We're giving postcards.
Yeah.
Digital wallpaper.
And digital wallpaper. I think we have something for everyone.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh, not to forget a big trip where we're inviting you to come to Kenya and, you know, we'll show you our country.
Yeah. So I think we have something for everyone. So yeah, with that.
Adios.
Koma imesa.